And once again, this is the realization of Dr. King's dream, a visible unity of people in the community standing together for that which is most sacred, the uplift of us all.
Our keynote speaker this morning has committed her life to the spirit of Dr. King's example of leadership.
Dr. Martin Luther King, the inspiration for our assembly today, would have turned 91 years old on Wednesday.
We have been called to the table of brotherhood to work out our differences and to join our hands to make this city, this state, and this country a better. And Virginia Union is ready for the task.
There is nothing greater in life, Dr. King tells us, than to do something for others.
It was Dr. King who told us to pray for the oppressor and use moral and spiritual force to carry on the struggle for justice.
As you all know, Dr. King visited Virginia Union many times to teach and speak. And among other things, he inspired the Richmond 34 to hold their sit-in at Tallheimer's lunch counter that eventually resulted in the desegregation of that store and other department stores.
Each year at this breakfast, we recognize the life work of community leaders and game changers from our Commonwealth. This year, we recognize 23 people who reflect the principles that emulate what Dr. King lived and died for throughout his short life.
We stand on the shoulders of a lot of individuals that have served before us. And one thing that I respect about Dr. Martin Luther King was he empowered others.
Please give another round of applause for our honorees, the Virginia Legislative Black Caucus. We appreciate their leadership and their service.